Hi there, it's Cassandra from the CAP University blog, and today I'm bringing you a video on a subject near and dear to my heart. No, it's not pumpkins, it's 3D printed part strength. With the variety of 3D printers on the market, it's hard to determine which printers and materials are best for your part needs. Whether you're creating prototypes or are interested in direct digital manufacturing, you need to research both printer and material capabilities. Luckily for you, I'm going to do some testing today. So today we're testing some 3D printed parts built on the Stratasys Fortus 250. The Fortus 250 is a fused deposition modeling 3D printer. For those of you unfamiliar with fused deposition modeling, or FDM for short, it's the only professional 3D printing technology that uses production grade thermoplastics, so parts are unrivaled in mechanical, thermal, and chemical strength. With FDM, you can build concept models, functional prototypes, and end-use parts in standard engineering grade and high-performance thermoplastics. With it being October, I'm going to print out some seasonal tools and test their designs and build for durability and strength. And what better tools to print this month than pumpkin carving tools? Let's see if I can print a durable carver and scoop to make a decent jack-o'-lantern. We found a few designs on Thingiverse.com. First was a jack-o'-lantern-inspired carver with a themed handle. With this tool, we'll be able to test if the Fortus 250 can accurately print intricate geometries like the face and ridges. We'll also see if the ABS plastic is strong enough to withstand some carving. The next tool is a smaller, kid-friendly carver with no sharp edges. With this tool, we'll be testing strength as well as print orientation. We'll be printing a total of 3 of these carvers to test which orientation and design works best. Lastly, we'll be printing a very important yet underrated tool for carving pumpkins, the scoop. The amount of pressure applied to spoons and scoops when cleaning a pumpkin can leave them mangled and sometimes broken. We'll be printing this scoop in 2 different orientations to see if the scoop design is durable enough and if the orientation makes a significant difference. The total print time for the first tray is about 12 hours. This is because of the 2 large scoops. Insight software for FDM 3D printers allows control over all build parameters, such as fill density. With the Fortus 250, we have 3 options for build density: sparse low density, sparse high density, and solid. To ensure the scoops and carvers are as strong as possible, we printed them with a solid density, making the print time longer. The orientation of the part in relation to the build plate will also affect the strength of the part and stepping on curved sections. We printed variations of the scoop in different orientations to test if the part will be stronger. We also re-engineered the small kid-friendly carver to have a full handle and printed 2 orientations to see if it will make a difference in strength when carving. The re-engineered carvers printed within 3 hours. So now that these are printed and ready, it's time to put them to the ultimate test. As you can see, some survived our strength test and some definitely did not. To improve this part design in the future, we'd recommend thickening the blade area to better survive chopping through a pumpkin, especially ones these size. Overall though, the ABS material proved to be very durable and printed detailed geometries beautifully for accurate, strong parts. All right. 3, 2,